Howdy folks, it's New Tool Monday, and we've got a saw in today that's, it's one of those ones I've wanted to buy, but when they first came on the market, they were like 350 bucks. Well, Dovaman's got a great price, and they have some great accessories to this thing, so we're going to be looking at this today. Yeah, let's go cut some wood. This saw has a lot of interesting features. And it's in that style that reminds me of the old Rockwell when they came out years ago. Like I said, they were over 300 bucks. Well, they're affordable now, so that's kind of nice. And I'm not big on doing, let's open the box and see what's inside. So I already got everything out. Yeah. There's the saw, but it also comes with a guide, which, you know, is pretty typical of most circular type saws. And it has a nice handle that'll hook on back here to help you to guide the saw when you're using it. This was the interesting part. It has a laser. So that was kind of like, yeah, that's kind of new. And it's a corded model. Now I prefer a corded model, and look at the cord they gave you. There is a lot of cord there. We'll measure and figure that out a little bit later. The big thing that I noticed here with this particular kit, which is really nice, is it comes with a 24 tooth blade, which is at least minimally, you know, a good rough cutting blade for wood. But it also comes with two of the rough cutting blades. Also comes with two of these 60 tooth blades, which is said to go through soft metal, which would be aluminum and maybe some sheet metal and some other things. We'll have to mess around with that. And of course, wood. And then it also comes with the tile cutters, which two blades for the tile cutting, which is great. So you got five blades plus this one. So you got six blades in total. With it is a 3,500 RPM unit. So it'll go pretty darn fast. Yep. And like I said, with the setup here, it does have the lock out here on this side. So if you're left-handed, you can easily hit that, I think. Let's see if you can do it. Yep. Or if you're right-handed, of course, you can use your thumb to, you know, do it. The overall, it's not as heavy as a big 7 1/4, you know, circular saw. So it's a little bit more portable that way. It's still a little heavy, don't get me wrong. But it's nice that you have a saw like this with a laser, and you can kind of guide it right up through. And of course, the handle is going to make it a lot safer. It also comes with this, which is kind of an odd one, because it you could sort of direct the sawdust in a certain direction if you'd like, which is a good thing, because let's face it, you really don't want the sawdust in front of you when you're using a laser especially. So that's kind of an interesting feature. But we got to get her plugged in, get some wood out, and we'll start cutting something with the laser and just see how all this goes. Looks good. And I gotta go find some aluminum. Pressure treat. Three-quarter inch plywood. Two by four. Maple hardwood. Okay, blade change, and now we're doing 60 tooth, and we're doing aluminum. Laminate flooring. Plastic, why not? I guess we could cut just about anything, I guess, today. I was gonna cut some PVC pipe, can't find any around the shop today for some reason. The cord is 10 feet long, so that's, yes. The other thing was this thing here, right here. Showed you, I stuck it on there, and it's full of sawdust that's collecting here. But again, you'd have to hook up a flexible vac line or something in order to actually pull the sawdust away from everything. It has a nice lever here, so you can set this up to, you know, adjust the depth of your saw. Notice it also changes the angle of the handle when you do that. It's kind of cool. And also it cuts up to 45 degree angles this way, so you got a little lever right here to unlock it. Now the screw here, just saw a big note here, but the screw is what they sometimes call a reverse thread, left-hand thread. It is a reverse screw. So it's just something to be aware of when you're tightening or loosening. When I changed blades, I discovered the blade that came in with the saw was just a tiny bit loose, so it actually needed to be tightened up, which they include, of course, an Allen wrench for that anyways. This handle, the way it goes on too, can go on this way or it can go over here. So you can, you know, set it on either side of the saw. So if you're right-handed or if you're left-handed, again, not a problem. So it is a nice featured circular saw. They call it a mini circular saw, and it sort of is for 4.5 inch, I guess. But depth-wise, let's get a tape measure and figure that out. I've got her set all the way down, so we'll just do it this way. We'll put the tape measure on it, and looks like it can cut, yeah, you'd get about 1.75 inches, roughly, on your depth for your blade, so that's not bad. Now, these blades have cut aluminum and a bunch of different things today, and this blade is still very, very sharp. You can feel the edge of it. It doesn't appear to be damaged or anything. I'm surprised, because the aluminum, I always thought you needed a carbide tip for aluminum, but I guess maybe you don't. I don't know. It's just, I thought a carbide would actually be better, but yeah, they include two of those blades. Now, the other one was tile. Again, I don't have any tile around, but if I did, I guess we could do that. The overall price of the saw is not bad. It's you know, it's a lot cheaper than what they used to be. They used to be so outrageously priced, these saws, that I just stopped looking and thought, eh, well, you know, maybe we'll come back to it some other time, because they were a very expensive saw when they first showed up on the market. They have really dropped in price, so that's a good thing. I turned the lights off in here, most of them, just so we could see this, but I just wanted to turn this on here and just show this to you, so that way there you can see there's the laser for laser guiding. It's on a separate switch on batteries, so make sure you shut it off when you're not using it. Wow, apologize, I got the 3D printer's farm running again in here with me today. Here's the thing, I'm going to provide a link in the description below, like I said, for this saw, but I'm also going to ask you, maybe check back in a few days or a week or so. Sometimes these companies like Dovaman here maybe they'll give us a, you know, discount coupon or something, and we can post that in the description below as well later on. Sometimes 48 hours or something like that goes by and then we get to post it. Meantime, yeah, that's a pretty handy, great little saw. Yes, and pretty good price, so yeah, I invite you to go check it out. Anyways, thank you so much for watching Coffee and Tools. Please like, share, subscribe, ring the notice bell. We give stuff away all the time, so hey, that was it. I'm out of here. Over and out.